خل القرآن يسدده خلق القرآن ويرشده يسعى في العلم ويؤثره ويثابر فيه ويسنده أولى حق لا يغفله حق المولى فيوحده ينقاد لشرعة خالقه ليس الشهوات تقيده إن سمع أو رأى كثر أضحى لله تعبده لا يتبع مهيع مبتدع يقف الهادي ويقلده والقلب سليم من مرض يحوي القرآن يمجده يتلو ما يتلو من ذكر يتدبره ويردده
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. This is Baba Salam and I welcome you to a new episode in the Juz Amma Practical Tajwid series brought to you by TVQ.Academy, your borderless school of the Qur'an. In today's episode of the Juz Amma Practical Tajwid series, as usual, we'll be going through a new surah which comes after all these surahs we have covered, in addition to the 6 dedicated episodes for the Arabic alphabet. Today's surah will be Surah Al-Balad. And in the episode of Surah Al-Balad, we will be having 3 main components as usual. The first will be reading the surah. The second will be highlight of some of the commonly made mistakes in reading Surah Al-Balad. And the final component will be discussion of a relevant tajweed topic to Surah Al-Balad. And today we have the points of articulations of the letter Qaf as well as the letter Kaf. Now that you are ready, let the excitement begin.
والقلب سليم من مرض يحوي القرآن يمجده يتلو ما يتلو من ذكر يتدبره ويردده
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا أقسم بهذا البلد وأنت حل بهذا البلد ووالد وما ولد لقد خلقنا الإنسان في كبد أيحسب أن لن يقدر عليه أحد يقول أهلكت مالا لبدا أيحسب أن لم يره أحد ألم نجعل له عينين ولسانا وشفتين وهديناه النجدين فلقتحم العقبة وما أدراك ما العقبة فك رقبة أو إطعام في يوم ذي مسغبة يتيما ذا مقربة أو مسكينا ذا متربة ثم كان من الذين آمنوا وتواصوا بالصبر وتواصوا بالمرحمة أولئك أصحاب الميمنة والذين كفروا بآياتنا هم أصحاب المشأمة عليهم نار مؤصدة. Let's repeat the surah one more time. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لا أقسم بهذا البلد. وأنت حل بهذا البلد ووالد وما ولد لقد خلقنا الإنسان في كبد أيحسب أن لن يقدر عليه أحد يقول أهلكت مالا لبدا أيحسب أن لم يره أحد ألم نجعل له عينين ولسانا وشفتين وهديناه النجدين فلاقتحم العقبة وما أدراك ما العقبة فك رقبة أو إطعام في يوم ذي مسغبة يتيما ذا مقربة أو مسكينا ذا متربة ثم كان من الذين آمنوا وتواصوا بالصبر وتواصوا بالمرحمة أولئك أصحاب الميمنة والذين كفروا بآياتنا هم أصحاب المشأمة عليهم نار مؤصدة
وإذا الخيرات له سنحت قنص الخيرات تصيده يتواضع لله الأعلى في كل مآلي يحمده.
Alright, moving on to highlighting some of the commonly made mistakes. We start by saying أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Some of the commonly made mistakes pertain to al-isti'adha and al-basmala. are highlighted in the episode of Surah Al-Fatiha. You may check it out. لا أقسم بهذا البلد. This over here, you can see the waveform, we call it, on top of the extension letter. And it indicates that we need to extend it up to 5 points. And the reason is because there is a Hamza right after that letter of extension, even though they are separated, they are in separate words. And we have learned this in the episode where we highlighted or discussed al-mad al-munfasil. لا أقسم بهذا البلد. And the other thing we need to pay attention to is the agitating or clicking the sound of the silent cough. أقو, أقسم. We don't say أقسم. And when we say أقو, we make it soft. We don't make it dry like كاف. أك, 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 for example. لا أقسم بهذا البلد. And بهذا. Pay attention to the little extension. هذا. And also say the, don't say, do not say za. Bihaza, no, please. Bihaza al-balad, all right? And the next will be al-balad. So as we mentioned about the clicking the sound or agitating the sound of the silent cough, the same thing applies to when we stop on this dal, together with the dal and the cough are among the 5 letters, which are the letters of al-qalqala. And we have talked about the letters of Al-Qalqala in the episode of Surah Al-Ikhlas and others as well. So we have Qaf, a silent Qaf, a silent Ba, a silent Jim, a silent Dal, and a silent Pa. And it becomes silent even when we stop on it, even when it is not silent naturally. But because when you stop on any letter in Arabic, we must apply silence to it, right? بِهَذَا الْبَلَدِ البلد وأنت حل بهذا البلد. Two things here to observe. The first is the ha. Make sure it comes from the point of ha and not from the point of ha. Do not say وأنت he hilun. Hilun can be ha, which comes from a different point of articulation, very close to ha hilun. And also it can be, sometimes some of us pronounce it like it comes from there, from the mouth here rather than from the throat. So do not say wa anta hi like it comes from the ceiling of the mouth. No, wa anta hi from the throat. Hillum bihada. And here we have qalb iqlab. We have tanween after which there is an active ba. So we apply wa anta hillum bihada. And this little meme indicates that you say hillum bihada. The noon. This, the noon of the tanween needs to be changed into a hidden or silent meme. حِلُّم بِهَذَا الْبَلَدِ وَوَالِدٍ وَمَا وَلَدِ. Remember, قَلْقَلَ here. لَقَدْ خَلَقَنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي كَبَدِ أَيَحْسَبُ. Alright, over here also we have ha, a silent ha. Do not say أَيَحْسَبُ. أَيَحْسَبُ. أَيَحْسَبُ أَنْ لَنْ يَقْدِرَ عَلَيْهِ أَحَدٍ أَلَّنْ يَا. Okay, we have a silent noon followed by an active lam. And the symbol of emphasis you see here on the lam indicates that this noon is merged in the lam, and therefore the silent noon here becomes like inexistent. So we say Allanya, Allanya. We don't say anlan, anlan. Do not give impression of the noon. Merge it in the lam and you are good to go. Ayahsabu Allanya Qodiro alayhi ahad. Yaqulu ahlaktu malal lubada. Ahlak, ahlak. Do not say ahlaktu, ahlaktu, ahlaktu. We need to apply some of the characteristics which include alhams. Alright, ahlak. And this becomes more prominent when this letter kaf is silent. When it is active, it goes hidden. All right. So we say yaqulu ahlaktu, ahlaktu. If it was active, then it will be it will be hidden. For example, وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ كَ. We don't say وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ كَ كَ. All right? يَقُولُ أَهْلَكْتُ مَالَ الْلُّبَدَى مَالَ الْلُّبَدَى. The same thing applies, we mentioned earlier on, أَلَّنْ يَقُدِرَ مَالَ الْلُّبَدَى. أَيَحْسَبُ, we have just explained this in a previous verse, أَيَحْسَبُ أَلَّمْ يَرَهُ أَحَدٍ. أَلَمْ نَجْعَلْ لَهُ عَيْنَيْنِ وَلِسَانًا وَشَفَتَيْنِ وَهَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجْدَيْنِ. Over here we have ha. This ha, we need to make sure that it is softer in comparison to ha. So please do not say وَهَدَيْنَاهُ, or even this one included وَهَدَيْنَاهُ. No. وَهَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجْدَيْنِ. And remember to apply the emphasis or غُنَّة on this emphasized noon. And why so? Because it is one of the letters of الشَّمْسِيَّة. وَهَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجْدَيْنِ فَلَقَتَحَمَ الْعَقَبَةِ. فَلَقَتَ. So we have a silent قَف here. So we have to say فَلَقَتَ قَ قَلْقَلَ. It is قَلَقَلَ صُغْرَ. فَلَقَتَحَمَ الْعَقَبَةِ. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الْعَقَبَةِ. فَلَقَتَحَمَ الْعَقَبَةِ. We have also here the ha. Pay attention to it and do not make it sound like فَلَقَتَحَمَ. فَلَقَتَحَمَ الْعَقَبَةِ. And we have الْعَقَبَةِ. Remember, this is ta, but it is a closed ta. It is not an open ta. So a closed ta, when we stop on it, we turn it into a silent ha. We have learned this in the dedicated episodes for the Arabic alphabet. So when we stop on a closed ta, we turn it into a silent ha. So therefore we say فَلَقَتَحَمَ الْعَقَبَةَ. الْعَقَبَةَ. We don't say الْعَقَبَةَ, silent, but a silent ha. الْعَقَبَةَ. We don't also say الْعَقَبَةَ unless the ta is open. All right? A boat ta, they say, we may call it. Unless the ta is open, then we can apply the silence of the ta itself. But anytime it is closed, please make sure if you stop on it, you turn it into a silent ha. فَلَقَتَحَمَ الْعَقَبَةِ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الْعَقَبَةِ. Remember, أَدْرَاكَ, we talk about it. When it is silent here, أَهْلَك. When it is active, we make it very simple, adraka, and then mal'aqabah, stop on a silent ha instead of al'aqabat. Fakuraqabah, you see, this kaf here, even though it is emphasized, we still do not apply the hams to it by saying fak, fak. No, fakku, unless we stop. If we stop, fak, yes. But if we link it, fakku, fakku, not fakku, 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 no. Fakuraqabah. أو إطعام في. We have also one of the five letters. When they are silent, we need to apply agitation to their sound, and that is what is known as قلقلة. أو إطعام. So look at the hamza before. The hamza is kasra, but it does not force us to make the ta, which is a heavy letter, although قلقلة, to make it flat by saying إط or إطعام. إط إط إط. أو إطعام في يوم ذي مسغبة. Pay attention to your ذال here and don't make it sound ذا instead ذي مسغبة. يتيما ذا مقربة أو مسكينا ذا متربة ثم كان من الذين آمنوا وتواصوا بالصبر وتواصوا بالمرحمة أولئك أصحاب أصحى أصى أص So ashabu. If you smile at it, as it becomes seen instead. Ulaika asa ashabul maymana. Walladhina kafaru bi ayatina. Hum ashabu. Ashabu already mentioned. Al-mash'ama. Al-mash'ama. Spread the sheen in your mouth. Al-mash'ama. Alayhim narum mu'sada. Alayhim narum mu'sada. We have a silent hamza after the emphasized meme. Mu-sada, mu-sada. So make sure it is a silent hamza and not and not waw, musada. In a different riwayah or qira, there is, but in hafs, we make sure that it is musada. All right? And with that, we have come to the end of the highlight of some of the commonly made mistakes in reading Surah Al-Balad.
أجمل بوفاء شيده وعفاف قل مشيده لا يخطو نحو مذممة شلت عن إجرام يده.
All right, moving on, let's take a look at the related tajweed topic to Surah Al-Balad, and today we have articulation of the letters Qaf and Kaf. But prior to that, we have already covered the articulation of Tha and Thal in Surah At-Tin. You can check it out. We have also covered the articulation of Dad and Dha in Surah Ash-Sharh. We have as well covered the articulation of the letters of the throat, which are six of them. You can check them in the episode of Surah Al-Layl. In the episode of Surah Ash-Shams, we covered the letters of the oral cavity. Today, by the will of Allah, we have these two letters, Qaf and Kaf. Qaf and Kaf come very close to the point of articulation. They are close to one another. It's one thing. The other thing is they come very close to the point of articulation of Ghayn and Kha. Let's take a look at Qaf first. Over here, Qaf is one of the letters that engages the tongue, and it is pronounced from the farthest back of the tongue by touching the soft palate over here, as you can see in the illustration, to create a thick sound. And the thick sound will be in the area of one's tonsil, all right? And let the sound be round. In other words, a heavy sound. Qa, qa. Look at here. If the back of your tongue can touch this soft palate in the vicinity of your tonsils, then you are good to go, because it will produce a soft and heavy, or rather round, sound for qa, qaf, qaf. So whether it is iqa, apply silence to the qaf and provide any active letter before it, you should be able to get it. Either it is iqa, 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 so you should feel it here. If you are feeling it somewhere here, or even below here, you are actually producing something else. And look at the position of the tongue. You have to stretch it this way to get close to it, inshallah. So basically, this is where we articulate our qaf from. Iqo, iqo, eqo, uqo. And once it is active, qa, qi, qu, qa, qi, qu. Do not say ka, ka, ka. If you say ka, it is actually kaf. Ka, ka. But, and you are saying, when you say ka, it is coming up from here rather than coming from this side. Ka. And likewise, when you say ki or qui, qui, for whatever the reason, or ku, it must be ka, ka, ka. That softness must be felt and heard. Iqa, ka, qi, qu. And you will be good to go. All right. Moving on, we have the letter kaf next to it. And kaf is also produced from the back of the tongue, just like we do to the qaf, except that the tongue is not elevated. It's rather slightly in front of the qaf. Take a look at the qaf. The qaf looks like this. You will make space inside your mouth and make the farther part of the tongue touch the soft palate lightly. Whereby in the case of kaf, you need to push your tongue slightly in front of the point of the articulation of the qaf. And it has to be dry. It has to be dry and crisp, if I may use that word. Ik, ik. Letter, remember in ahlak to ahlak, ik, ak, uk, and whatnot. So we have qaf and kaf coming from more or less the same point of articulation, only that how we position our tongue and manipulate our tongue will make the qaf soft and the kaf dry. And remember, the qaf is a heavy letter and the kaf is a light letter, and you will be good to go. Now let's take a look at Surah Al-Balad one more time to see where we have qaf and kaf. Of course, everything in Surah Al-Balad has Tajwid requirement and is worth the time to reflect Tajwid wise. But the focus today is more on Qaf and Kaf. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. La uqo. Uqo. So don't say uqo, uqo, ko. It becomes Kaf with heaviness. Uqo simu bihadha al-balad. Wa anta hillum bihadha al-balad. Wa walidin wa ma walad. Laqad, we have qa. Laqad khalaqa, we have qaf. Laqad khalaqna al-insana fi ka. Ka. Fi kabad. And never say fi kabad. Ka, ka. Fi kabad. Ayahsabu al-lain yaqo. Yaqo dira alayhi. We have qaf. Yaqo dira alayhi ahad. Yaqo, qo, qoolu. Yaqoolu ahlak. Look at the ahlak. Ahlak tu ma lallubada. أَيَحْسَبُ أَنْ لَمْ يَرَهُ أَحَدٌ أَلَمْ نَجْعَلْ لَهُ عَيْنَيْنِ وَلِسَانًا وَشَفَتَيْنِ وَهَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجْدَيْنِ فَلَقَطَ we have here قَاف فَلَقَطَ حَمَلْ عَقَبَ قَاف as well وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ أَدْرَاكَ وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا الْعَقَبَ الْعَقَبَ فَكُّ we have emphasized كَاف over here فَكُّ رَقَبَ we have قَاف as well أَوْ إِطْعَامٌ فِي يَوْمٍ ذِي مَسْغَبَةٍ يَتِيمًا ذَا مَقْرَبَةٍ قَاف أَوْ مِسْكِينًا أَوْ مِسْكِينًا أَوْ مِسْكِينًا ذَا مَتْرَبَةٍ ثُمَّ كَانَ مِنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْمَرْحَمَةِ أُولَئِكَ أولئك أصحاب الميمنة والذين كفروا كا كا you can feel it once you already identify where it comes from والذين كفروا بآياتنا هم أصحاب المشأمة عليهم نار مؤصدة this is another reading to reinforce everything we have read in Surah Al-Balad أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا أقسم بهذا البلد وأنت حل بهذا البلد ووالد وما ولد لقد خلقنا الإنسان في كبد أيحسب أن لن يقدر عليه أحد يقول أهلكت مالا لبدا أيحسب أن لم يره أحد ألم نجعل له عينين ولسانا وشفتين وهديناه النجدين فلقتحم العقبة وما أدراك ما العقبة فك رقبة أو إطعام في يوم ذي مسغبة يتيما ذا مقربة أو مسكينا ذا متربة ثم كان من الذين آمنوا وتواصوا بالصبر وتواصوا بالمرحمة أولئك أصحاب الميمنة والذين كفروا بآياتنا هم أصحاب المشأمة عليهم نار مؤصدة All right, with that we have come to the end of today's episode of the Juz Amma Practical Tajwid series brought to you by TVQ.Academy Your borderless school of the Qur'an. Until we meet again in our next episode, I leave you in Allah's protection. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah.
وإلى الآباد يخلده هذا مني وأنا منه وفضائله ستسوده طابت في الدنيا عيشته وعوالي الجنة موعده موعده